Passage 92. So my dear students, today I will give you some exercise on passage narration and their solution. You please go through the text very carefully. Exercise 1. What is your program after the examination? Asked Salam. Kamal said, I have not yet decided. Can you suggest any? Let us go on a picnic, said Salam. What an excellent idea. I shall certainly join you, said Kamal. So in this passage, you can see Salam and Kamal are speaker and listener. So the solution is, Salam asked Kamal what his program was after the examination. Kamal replied that he had not yet decided. He asked him if he could suggest him any program. Salam proposed that they should go on a picnic. Kamal exclaimed with joy that it was an excellent idea. He also said that he would certainly join him. So here, in the very first sentence, Salam is asking Kamal about their program. And in reply, Kamal said he had not yet decided. So he then asked if Salam could suggest him any program. Then Salam proposed that they should go on a picnic. Then Kamal became very excited and appreciated the idea, and then he wanted to join the program. The next exercise number 2. The teacher said to the boy, do you know that honesty is the best policy? In the very first sentence, you can see that the teacher is asking a boy a question. The boy said, yes, sir, I think so. So the boy here also replied by saying yes, and he also said about his thinking. So, learn to be honest, said the teacher. Here, in the next one, the teacher advised the boy to be honest. Then the boy said, thank you, sir. May Allah grant you a long life, said the teacher to the boy. So you can see that the teacher prayed for the boy for his long life. So the passage is, the teacher said to the boy, do you know that honesty is the best policy? The boy said, yes, sir, I think so. Learn to be honest, said the teacher. Thank you, sir, said the boy. May Allah grant you a long life, said the teacher to the boy. The answer is, the teacher asked the boy if he knew that honesty is the best policy. The boy respectfully replied in the affirmative that he thought so. The teacher advised him to learn to be honest. The boy respectfully thanked the teacher. The teacher prayed that Allah might grant him a long life. The third exercise. The man said to the manager, "May I come in, sir?" "Yes, come in. What do you want?" said the manager. "I want to open a bank account in your bank," said the man. "Can you tell me how I can open a saving account?" The answer is, the man respectfully asked the manager if he might go in. The manager replied in the affirmative that he might go in. He also asked him what he wanted. The man replied that he wanted to open a bank account in his bank. He also asked him if he could tell him how he could open a saving account. Verse number 4. Rashid said to Karim, "How are you? I went to your hostel yesterday but did not find you. Where did you go?" "I went to the station," said Karim. "I had to receive my maternal uncle there." You can see the answer. Rashid asked Karim how he was. He added that he had gone to his hostel the previous day, but he had not found him. Then he asked him where he had gone. Karim replied that he had gone to the station and he had gone to receive his maternal uncle. Exercise number 5. The old man said, "Can you give me some food? I have been starving for 3 days." The maid said, "Why do you beg? Can't you work?" "No, I am unable to work," said the old man. See the answer. The old man asked the maid if she could give him some food. He added that he had been starving for 3 days. The maid asked him why he begged and why he could not work. The old man replied in the negative that he was unable to work. Exercise number 6. "What is the time by your watch?" He said, "It's 10:30. I said. He said, "I want to go to college. Would you accompany me, please?" "No, I'm sorry," replied I. Answer. He asked me what the time was by my watch. I replied that it was 9:30. He said that he wanted to go to college. Then he politely asked me if I would accompany him. I replied in the negative that I was sorry. Exercise number 7. "Good morning, students," said the teacher. "How are you?" "We're fine, sir," What about you? Aren't you? Please, sit down. Have you prepared your lesson? The teacher asked. Sorry, sir. We have not prepared our lesson, they replied. So, my dear students, the answer will be, the teacher wished the students good morning and asked how they were. The students respectfully replied that they were fine and asked the teacher what about him. The teacher replied that he was fine too and told them to sit down. He also asked the students if they had prepared their lesson. The students respectfully said that they were sorry and added that they had not prepared their lesson. Exercise number 8. Will you go to school today? Mother said to her son. No, mother. Our classes are suspended. Then go to market and bring some vegetables. Let me be ready and give me money. Sir, mother asked her son if he would go to school that day. Addressing her affectionately, he replied in the negative and said that their classes were suspended. Then mother told him to go to market and bring some vegetables. The son requested his mother that he might be ready and told her to give him money. The last exercise, and it's a critical one. But if you go through it very carefully, then it will be clear to you. Excuse me, are you Jack? Said Rana. No, I am not. He is over there, said Saki. Oh, I'm sorry, said Rana. Are you a new student here? Said Saki. Yes, I am. The answer will be, Rana excused Saqib and asked if he was Jack. Saqib replied in the negative that he was not. He added that he was over there. Rana exclaimed that he was sorry. Saqib asked if he was a new student there. Rana replied in the affirmative that he was. So, my dear students, thank you very much for enjoying the class.